in the nursery out of her own pocket.
Yeah, she wrote newspaper articles to earn a living. This is her chair here.
It was a chair that was here from the old Deer Park Hotel. When the Secret Service could make her, she sat in there at the station master's office behind lock and key. But being Eleanor, a lot of times she sat out here. And why they came here and not to tear out a station, which is closer, we always had the side train.
It's a fire extinguisher.
Yep, it's a hardened grenade.
Look at that.
Fire extinguisher. I guarantee you that one's filled with water. Because if it was filled with its original chemical, it could not be here even in a display case.
No.
It didn't deteriorate. No. Just a little tad dangerous. It was phosphane, which used to be used in steel making. When you close a bus. the other side of D.C., quicker and easier is better.
Oh, Alex, did you take a picture of this beautiful picture? You can see our church in the courthouse.
This chair was used a great deal by Eleanor Roosevelt.
However,
in 1933, out past Terre Haute and Kingwood, going towards Reedsville, they started a New Deal community called Arthur Dale.
Yeah, uh-huh.
She liked Arthur Dale so well from 1933. If there was nurses on the train, she worked with the carriers. The first air conditioner in the United States was on a B&O dining car.
Right. She worked with a book about her, they should. Oh, there it is right there.
This is the little kid's book.
Oh, I love that.
And I keep it here for the little kids to tell about it.
Yeah.
She graduated college twice. She graduated in her 20s as a mathematician and was teaching school. In her 30s, she decided that she wanted to be a civil engineer. Her innovations were shamelessly copied by the other railroads in Pullman. She put reclining bucket seats on the train so you could sleep on them if you needed to.
She was the first to do that.
He also seen that the ventilation system was good, kept all the smoke smell and all the soot and embers out. She made the least. In the 1920s, the B&O pirate. She designed all the blue wear and holy presidential wear on the train.
All of Dennis.
There she is in her Cincinnati Inn.
And what else did you say? Everything did she
do? Yes, she worked with the Carrier Brothers. See, I wasn't lying to you when I said she was on Google.
Yeah, no.
And she is in the book of Maryland women. How she was even found out. Now, being on, she was always in your archives. You know that.
Mm-hmm.
How she was found out, believe it or not, the lady was in here giving a talk, and that's how I. Don't forget to look up.
Oh, wow.
That passed. Hurt because I figured there was some shook up folks.
Yeah.
But he obliterated the payroll clerk. Hurt because I figured there was some shook up folks.
Yeah.
But he obliterated the payroll. Well, I guess nobody got paid today. And here, if you like that, you might want this. We just got it out of the road for the Christmas displays. You might want that. But that's American Railroad Morse code, which is slightly different than International Morse code.
What's the difference between the two?
It's some lettering
cool.
That train you spoke back there are handmade, one of a kind, made out of tin cans of scrap. It's either over or overhead.
Yeah.
Right now it's over. But I can see that the radar says it's coming. It's coming. We can't miss it.
We got a derailment.
Florida, namely me. So it had to migrate. It did on yesterday evening. And why she wasn't allowed to marry, the kind of people she associated with was President Harrison's wife, Mrs. Coolidge, and
yes.
Just basically they weren't good enough for his precious little daughter. And then she also, her and her girlfriends did what they called the Friday night. They'd get out and talk about books and stuff they read, and they all decided they weren't going to marry.
Hey, Mom, look, N-scale.
Z-scale.
Yes, very tiny.
And very expensive.
So I heard.
Well, that little engine right there starts at 800.
Wow.
Well, think of how small them electric motors are around that wheel.
I agree.
She never heard.
An engineering nightmare there.
Hey, look, Mom, it's approach. Look at the signal. Behind you. Behind you.
What?
Approach.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You don't see, have you ever seen any of the geared engines?
You mean like Shays? I went to Cass. I went to Cass years ago.
Shays, Chrysler's, Climax, and J.P. Mars are the four I know of. And I've only seen one picture of a J.C. Mars.
It's on here. That's my channel. I'll post the
video
there.
Because it was tiny. It was like, it weighed about as much as the Tom Thumb weighed, about 3.5 to 5 tons.
Yeah.
It was a little tiny.